Let's see the epic showdown between the XPS 15 and the new MacBook Pro 16. Which one's better? Or more importantly, which one's better for you? Let's find out. So, if you guys are new around here, come on, sub up, join the Woo Train, hit that bell, ding-a-ling-a-dong, so you don't miss any of my videos. And if you like my video, why not? Give it a nice thumbs up there. And thank you for Mr. Rodriguez, Daniel Rodriguez, for supporting me on Patreon, which I have links down there, with PayPal donations. If you want to help support the channel, totally up to you. So since last decade to around 2015, the MacBook Pro was the king of the 15-inch premium content creator laptop. But from late 2015, the XPS 15 was launched, and that has been the reigning king ever since. Now, has the new 2019 MacBook Pro 16 taken its crown? Well, let's find out. When it comes to price, be no surprise to you, Apple costs more. I mean, there are going to be some crazy sales with Dell on Black Friday. You're going to be able to pick up one of these XPS 15s really cheap. And conceivably, you could get one of these XPS 15s similar spec for well over $1,000 US cheaper. The Mac started a good starting price for what they are and the resale value you get. I mean, when you configure it with the i9, it's actually really cheap compared to some other models. But value, XPS 15 wins here. It's amazing the price you can pick up the XPS 15 at sometimes. When it comes to design and build quality, well, it's going to be personal preference, but they are both premium laptops, and that's why I love these two. You know, I want a premium metal build, and I want it to look like it's metal. Don't want it to be aluminium and then be black or something like that. Premium CNC machined aluminium laptops here, both great build quality, both are aging sort of designs. If you look when they were first designed, you know, 2016, same sort of design as this MacBook Pro 16, and XPS 15 been out since late 2015, but they still look bang up to date and modern. Although the MacBook Pro doesn't have the Infinity Edge, so it does have bezel at the top, but then the XPS 15 does have a bit of a chin, so the MacBook Pro has a smaller chin. So it just depends where you put the display, I guess. But given that this is the latest MacBook Pro and it's just been released, you're comparing it to something that, you know, was designed in 2015. And just remember, there's a new XPS 15 coming out in January, and that should be a new design. And I think it's going to be more of a change than the MacBook Pro is compared to the last 15-inch MacBook Pro. And there's going to be 17-inch XPS. So please don't complain that I'm comparing the latest MacBook Pro to what is probably the outgoing XPS 15. The roadmap says probably CES, they're going to announce the new one unless there's been some sort of delay. And I will, of course, compare them again once that new one comes out, but we have to compare what is out at the moment. So I don't think there's a winner anyway with design and build quality. They're both good. And when it comes to specs, just want to point out some key points from both of them. Both use the same processors, except the XPS 15, you can unlock and overclock that i9. So you can get up to 5.1 gigahertz single threaded. MacBook Pro, you can't overclock it or undervolt it, but it does go up to 4.9 gigahertz in single threaded stuff. So that's pretty good. But both 9th generation CPUs, no difference there. Same amount of RAM, 64 gigabytes. When it comes to storage, oh my God, the Mac, 8 terabytes. Wow, that is amazing. Of course, with the XPS 15, you have an M.2 slot, which you can upgrade to whatever size M.2 comes out, as long as Dell make a BIOS to support whatever. If they bring out a 4 or 8 terabyte M.2 SSD, you should be able to use it on the XPS 15, but the maximum is 2 terabytes from Dell. Weight and thickness, you know, the XPS 15 looks a bit more squat and a bit more compact, a little bit chunkier. The weight is pretty much the same now, except the MacBook Pro is a bigger overall footprint, so it looks a bit more squashed out. Some people say it looks like a lunch tray, but it is thinner. Both similar to handle, but the Mac is a 16-inch. Now you'll see that the XPS 15 does have Wi-Fi 6. You cannot get it on the MacBook Pro, which is a big deal to me. You're getting over 30% faster transfer speed with Wi-Fi 6 on the XPS 15 versus the MacBook Pro. And in actual fact, the XPS 15 can transfer files pretty much as fast as gigabit Ethernet. When it comes to graphics, you have the 4GB GTX 1650 with the XPS 15, and you have two versions of the Radeon Pros that you can get with the MacBook Pro, the 5300 and the 5500. You also have an 8GB option with the 5500 with the MacBook Pro 16. That also has GDDR6 versus GDDR5. On the XPS 15, I've already done a lot of testing on it. Indeed, the graphics are faster on the MacBook Pro, which it never was. This time it is. And the 8GB of video memory will make a huge difference. in certain workflows and application. Big batteries on both of them, 99 watt hour versus 97, big batteries. And that's sort of like the biggest takes out of the specs. I think now if you take Wi-Fi 6 out of the equation, MacBook Pro does have an edge in the specs because of the graphics card. I haven't talked about displays yet, I'll get to that. When it comes to ports, you get 4 Thunderbolt 3 ports on the MacBook Pro 16. You do not get USB Type-A, you do not get an SD card slot, you do not get HDMI, which you do get on the XPS 15. You also get Thunderbolt 3 on the XPS 15 as well. You know, super bandwidth with 4 Thunderbolt 3 ports on the MacBook Pro, but it's not very convenient. So if you're someone that wants and need ports, the only choice is the XPS 15. But if you don't mind carrying around dongles, there's a lot of versatility in 4 Thunderbolt 3 ports. You just got to remember the dongle, right? I forgot it before, and I guarantee you'll forget it as well one time. So you're going to get screwed in one point of time. Now, when it comes to keyboard, it's going to be personal preference here. They both have decent keyboards. I think the difference between the two is slightly less travel on the MacBook Pro, although the keys are bigger and they feel softer. The XPS 15, the keys are smaller and the plastic is harder. So it's a different feel to them. Which one's better? I don't know. It's really going to come down to personal preference. We know that these Magic Keyboards are reliable because they're basically the Magic Keyboard off the iMac. So I don't have any issues with the MacBook Pro keyboard being durable now. Try them both out. They're both decent keyboards. When it comes to trackpad though, MacBook Pro wins on the trackpad. Easy win there. The XPS 15 does have one of the best Windows trackpad, but it's not on the same level. When it comes to displays, let's spend a little bit of time on this. You can look at the displays now. And what you'll notice when you're looking at these two is one, woof, that contrast, that kick in the plums, saturation, sharpness of the XPS 15 is just phenomenal. 16:9 display. So it is actually better for watching content. Also, it's just better in general for watching content because of that sharpness, that contrast, that beautiful pop it has on the MacBook Pro 16. You get a gorgeous 16:10 display, much more vertical real estate. I'd say overall it's more color accurate out of the box, and the colors are more realistic and more neutral. When you look at them side by side, everybody says the XPS is better. Like people that, you know, not colorists and stuff like that. If you just see them side by side, everybody's going to pick the XPS 15, whether it's the OLED or the 4K LED touch display, which you have the two options, and one of them is, you know, 100% P3, one of them is 100% Adobe RGB, which is the LED, P3 is the OLED. With the MacBook Pro, it is 100% P3, 500 nits of brightness, or will you get 500 nits of brightness? Who knows? There's a lot of big variations in panel brightness with the MacBook Pros, and this is going back to actually 2016. There's been a huge difference in panel brightness. Now, every panel is different, and the same with the XPS 15. You're never going to get two the same, but you know, when you're talking over 100 nits difference in brightness, that's a bit too much. Now, the LED 4K touch on the XPS 15, it has just retina blowing brightness. Like, it measures 700 and something nits. That's because it has hot whites. It's not actually that bright, but it is certainly the brightest out of all of them. On the spec sheet, it says 500. The OLED is the least brightest on the spec sheet. But when you see the OLED at 200% at 4K, because, you know, the XPS displays are 4K, remember. I think you can see the difference in sharpness now. This is 4K content plane of both. You've never seen anything like that. 200% scaling, super sharp OLED. It's just phenomenal. Although I do choose the LED over the OLED just because it's brighter, better battery life on the XPS 15. Has OLED traits as well. That's super sharp, super bright. I can't choose between those two, the OLED and the LED on the XPS 15. Good luck for me to choose between that and the 16:10 on the MacBook Pro. It's 16 inch too, it's bigger and more color accurate out of the box. Of course, you can tone down the XPS 15, but if you have a look now, you'll see in the reds and the browns, it does look ghastly compared to the MacBook Pro 16, but you can calibrate it. And the thing I say is, while the Mac is more color accurate out of the box, you can never get that sharpness, pop, and contrast that you get with the XPS 15 displays. But you can make the XPS 15 displays more color accurate like the MacBook Pro. But then again, you're stuck with 16:9 on the XPS 15. You don't get that extra real estate on the 16:10. So good luck choosing between them. I don't know which one's better. Do you know what? In a perfect world, I'd have a 16:10, but I'd have the brightness of the XPS LED, but the pop and contrast of the OLED XPS 15. It would be nice if I could combine them all together and get the best attributes out of each display. But I know when I edit on both of them, with the XPS 15, I have to watch out for saturation. I know that even though what I'm looking at looks saturated on the XPS 15, I have to know that it's not going to look that good on other displays. So I have to compensate for that. Then with the MacBook Pro, and I see all that detail in the blacks, I've got to remember that on other displays, you're not going to see that detail. So I've got to compensate for that with the Mac. Let me know down there in the comments which one you think is better. When it comes to battery life, the Mac has the better battery life. You will get in excess of 10 hours just normal web surfing, email, that sort of stuff. The XPS 15 with the 4K display, higher resolution means less battery life. That's probably one of the reasons why Apple haven't gone the higher resolution display. So you're good for around 8 hours with the XPS 15 if you're just doing general web surfing and stuff. I lower my screen right down with the XPS 15 and I'm able to get around that 8 hours. But no doubt the MacBook Pro has better battery life. When it comes to upgradability, you cannot upgrade anything on the Mac. You have to buy what you need and think about the future. The XPS 15, you can just get the CPU you want and then get the cheapest of everything else and then just upgrade it over time. And when new stuff comes out, you'll be able to put it in there, like new bigger SSDs. Laptops with soldered in stuff are less likely to have issues like, you know, RAM and SSDs being unseated. So they can be more reliable in that way. But I've never had any RAM unseated in my laptops. But let me know if you have. I'd like to really know if that's really an issue. When it comes to performance, I've done a lot of performance tests between these XPS 15 and the MacBook Pro 16. So check out those videos. I've got a MacBook Pro 16 playlist. You'll see, you know, gaming benchmarks, content creation benchmarks between the two. Very similar performance with the CPUs, 56 watts. The XPS 15 is limited to, you will get more than 60 watts sustained with the MacBook Pro. So it wins in that sort of department. But when you light up the GPU and CPU together, you will get more sustained power or wattage with the XPS 15 because it's a 130 watt package versus 96 watts on the MacBook Pro 16. Also, of course, you can undervolt and overclock that i9 in the XPS 15 as well. So CPU, yeah, not much difference. But the GPU, yeah. The MacBook Pro has faster GPU now. There's no doubt, especially when you can get the 8GB option. It's faster even for gaming. Although I do think the gaming on the XPS 15 is a better experience just because, you know, you don't get battery drain so much. You don't have to mess about with boot camp and weird resolutions. Some games will only let you play because the 16x10 display on the Mac. But overall performance between the two, similar thermal packages now, but the Mac edges are here because it's got the 8GB faster graphics now. Now, in conclusion, which one is the best? And that's been a long reign that the XPS 15 has had of being the king since 2015. And remember, there is a new one coming out in January, or at least being announced. And I think it's really hard to argue overall if you encompass everything, upgradability, value, display options, touch display, you know, OLED, ports. It's hard to argue overall the XPS 15 is the better laptop. But take away some of that stuff and just look, hey, I've got the top spec of both of these, which one is the best? I've just got to give it to the MacBook Pro here. And the two things that make the MacBook Pro edge it for me is the better battery life and the better graphics options here. You know, 8GB Radeon Pro graphics. And remember, these graphics are pro. You get to use the pro drivers in Windows, pro drivers in macOS. And for apps that use these pro drivers, it is of an order of a magnitude faster. Just raw speed between the two graphics cards, taking professional graphics drivers out of it, it's still faster than the XPS 15's graphics. So the better battery life and the better graphics just gives it to the MacBook Pro here. We're going to have to revisit this when the next XPS 15 comes out. But the Mac, I've got to hand it to them now. Apart from Wi-Fi 6, apart from that, they got a winner here. They listened to the pros. They've done everything the pros wanted. You got to just tip your hats off to them. So, yeah, thank you for watching, guys. I'll catch you in the next one. Tally ho.